Professor Dave again, let's multiply matrices.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned how to add and subtract matrices, so let's move on to the next logical operation. It is also possible to multiply two matrices together. This is not as simple as matrix addition, as we will not simply be multiplying corresponding entries to get new entries. Instead, we have to learn a totally different algorithm, so let's check that out now. The first thing we must learn is that in order for two matrices to be multiplied, they must have a specific relationship in terms of their dimensions, and it is not the case that they must have identical dimensions. Rather, if two matrices A and B are being multiplied with A listed first, followed by B, it will be the case that A must have the same number of columns as B has rows. The reason for this will be clear in a moment. Let's start with a pair of simple 2x2 matrices. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, 6, 7, 8. The way we will get the product is by taking the first row of the first matrix and the first column of the second matrix and doing some multiplication. 1 times 5 is 5, and 2 times 7 is 14. 5 plus 14 is 19, so that goes in the first entry of the product matrix. Now we stay in the first row of this matrix, but shift over to the second column of the other. 1 times 6 is 6, and 2 times 8 is 16. 6 plus 16 is 22, and that will go in the second entry for the first row of the product matrix. Now we shift to the second row of the first matrix and go back to the first column of the second matrix. 3 times 5 is 15, 4 times 7 is 28. 15 plus 28 is 43. So that will go in the first entry for the second row of the product matrix. And lastly, we shift to the second column again. 3 times 6 is 18, 4 times 8 is 32. 18 plus 32 is 50, and that will go in the last entry here. This is the algorithm we will follow for matrix multiplication. We are using rows from the first matrix and columns from the second matrix, and we are finding the sum of the products of the corresponding entries. This explains why the first matrix has to have the same number of columns as the second matrix has rows. Take something like this 2x3 matrix times this other 3x2 matrix. These can be multiplied in this order, and once we begin, we can see that the three entries in the first row of this one correspond to the three entries in the first column of this one. We add up the numbers, and there is our first entry in the product matrix. Then we use the second column, and then we repeat this process for the second row of the first matrix. This gives us a product matrix that is 2x2. So the product matrix will always have a number of rows that is equal to the number of rows in the first matrix, and a number of columns that is equal to the number of columns in the second matrix. This also tells us an important fact that may not have been immediately intuitive. Although the multiplication of numbers is commutative, meaning that A times B is the same as B times A, this will not be the case for matrix multiplication. Take the 2x3 and 3x2 matrices we just multiplied together. If we switch their order, we will get a completely different result, a product matrix that is 3x3 rather than 2x2. As you can see, the three rows from the first one and the three columns from the second one will determine these dimensions. So matrix A times matrix B is not equivalent to matrix B times matrix A. However, matrix multiplication is associative, meaning that if we are multiplying three matrices in a specific order, it doesn't matter which pair we multiply first. In addition, the distributive property can apply in some cases. If A and B are M by N matrices and C and D are N by P matrices, meaning that A and B can each be multiplied by C or D, then A times the quantity C plus D will equal AC plus AD, and the quantity A plus B times C will equal AC plus BC. Now that we know the algorithm associated with matrix multiplication, as well as some associated properties, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.